just wanted that message at that moment and blew up. Ice-T comes right behind them. So now the swing went from the East Coast to the West Coast. And the West Coast had it for a moment. And Dr. Dre was in them, NWA. And Dr. Dre is one of our big, big hip-hop producers. And he actually conformed and looked for something else to do with the sound other than the boom-bap tradition. Boom, bap, boom, bap, boom, bap type of tradition of the East Coast. And so one of the things that he did was he dropped the tempo from 100 beats per minute to about 120 beats per minute that was in a traditional boom-bap to about 90 beats per minute. Boom, 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 boom. Music scene was like, what is this? And the West Coast snatched all the work. I remember because I was working that. And I was like, whoa, I'm not working right now. What's going on? Do I need to hustle me up on the West Coast? The problem was that music evolves. And that guacamole evolved, the blues evolved, strike piano evolved. So, of course, funk was going to evolve. And the next thing after funk was going to evolve was hip hop. But I couldn't identify it then. I didn't know that this thing that we now call hip hop was the next thing. I thought people were going to be standing on stage playing instruments. And the true innovation of hip-hop is that it deconstructed our